Wherever you go, you find aluminium. In buildings, in boats, planes and cars, household appliances, in packaging, computers, cell phones, containers for drinks and foods. Aluminium is an important metal for the future due to its strength, lightness and excellent potential for recycling. Hydro is the world's third largest aluminium producer, with more than 19,000 employees in 40 countries. Hydro's plant at Karmøy was opened in 1967. It was the company's first smelter. Three different raw materials are required to make aluminium: aluminium oxide, electricity and carbon. Oxide comes to Karmøy by boat from Brazil and Jamaica. It's unloaded and stored in silos. From there, it's carried on conveyor belts to the pot rooms. Cranes pour the oxide into day tanks on each cell. An automated system ensures that each cell gets precisely the amount of oxide it needs. The second raw material is electricity, generated from Norwegian hydropower. The plant at Karmøy uses 2.6 terawatt hours per year. This power mainly comes from Hydro's own generating station at Nesflaten in Suldal. The third raw material is carbon. Anodes and cathodes are made of carbon. The anodes we use at Karmøy are produced in the Netherlands and at Røldal in Norway. When the anodes arrive at Karmøy, they're attached to the anode hangers in the anode assembly. Used anodes wait here for recycling, as well as new anodes ready to be installed in the cells. Before a new anode is installed in the cell, the surface of the liquid metal must be completely pure. Therefore, the cell must be cleaned. An anode lasts 26 days before it needs replacing. The quality of the anode is of great importance both for even aluminium production and the environment. Aluminium production is continuously monitored by the specialists in the electrolysis department. The pot room at Karmøy is approximately 800 meters long. The 288 electrolytic cells produce 180,000 tons of liquid aluminium annually. Hydro has 900 employees at Karmøy. In this facility today, we use 13.1 kilowatt hours to produce 1 kilogram of aluminium. There are few smelters in the world that are more energy efficient producers than Karmøy. The metal is removed from the cells using motorized vehicles. At a temperature of 970 degrees, it's drawn up from the cell into a container called a melting pot. The liquid metal is transported to one of three casting areas: strip casting in the rolling mill, wire rod casting, or extrusion ingot casting. The rolled products area at Karmøy is one of the few places in the world that produces approximately 5 millimeter thick discs directly from liquid metal. Typically, discs are rolled down from blocks that are approximately 6 meters long, 60 centimeters thick, and weigh several tons. The 5 millimeter thick discs are rolled more thinly and are used in products for the building and transportation industries and transformers, to name just a few. The second cast house makes aluminium wire rod with diameters from 5 to 25 millimeters. This wire rod is later rolled more thinly by the customer and is used in the production of high voltage cables, amongst other things. Extrusion ingot is made by pouring the liquid aluminium into a casting form, then pressing the ingot down into the form. An extrusion ingot is 7.5 meters long and weighs from 600 kilograms to 2.5 tons, depending on its diameter. Products go through an extensive quality control process before delivery to the customer, such as here, where we use ultrasonic testing to see if there are any internal cracks. Extrusion ingot comes in full lengths or is cut into lengths of about 1 meter, referred to as a billet. Our customers set high quality requirements for the metal's properties. When errors occur, it's of great importance to be able to trace products back to their production, and therefore all products are marked with a production number and the alloy type. The aluminium is forced through a press tool made of hardened steel, creating the new profile. The customer's needs are met in collaboration with our designers. Extrusion ingot is the raw material for extrusion plants in Europe, which produce aluminium profiles from them. These profiles have many applications and are mainly used in the construction, automotive and other transportation industries, in electronics and in the offshore sector. Research and development is central to Hydro's efforts to develop high technology, high quality products in the most environmentally responsible way. One of Hydro's research centres is based at Karmøy. This centre works with quality testing of extrusion ingot and aluminium profile products. Electron microscopes are used to analyse metal structures at the molecular level. The centre also has its own laboratory to test surfaces and environmental impacts on the products. Again, here we work closely with our customers to find the best solutions. Products from Karmøy are delivered to customers throughout Europe. Customers in Scandinavia receive their products by truck, while the majority of the products from Karmøy leave the factory area by ship. Hydro at Karmøy emphasizes vocational training. 80% of the operators have an apprenticeship certificate. It's also a strength to have the research center closely connected to the production unit. Aluminium production occurs on a global scale. What separates producers from each other is the expertise of the employees and thus the product's quality and customization for the customer. The high competence of the employees is often essential in delivering high-quality products that meet both customer needs and today's stringent environmental requirements. Together with our employees, we are determined to be a world leader in aluminium production.